Yes, it's true. An NBA comeback is coming. Love is love.
I wanna go far, there's no stopping. I see them watching, I see them waiting. One day I swear I'ma be on the station. Mama, I gotta make moves.
Before we start this video, I wanna shout out my sponsor, SeatGeek. The NBA season is approaching and the NFL season is here, and SeatGeek is literally the greatest place to get your tickets. SeatGeek is an app that puts tickets from all over the web in one place, making your job easy as can be. They rate these deals on a scale of 1 to 100 to let you know whether you're getting a good deal or not. I mean, they even give you a visual of what your seats will actually look like. If you plan to go to a game without this app, you're literally robbing yourself. And if you use my promo code SWISHOUT, you get $20 off of your first purchase. So with that being said, I'll drop the link in the description, and I truly hope you guys take advantage of this amazing app. I know I am. Stephon Marbury was an emerging superstar. Besides his final season in Boston, he never averaged fewer than about 14 points per game, not even as a rookie. And speaking of rookies, in 1996, he came in with one of the most dynamic little players in NBA history, Allen Iverson. But with Stephon Marbury, what happened to his NBA career? Because he really wasn't completely finished when he played his final game in Boston. So what happened to his NBA career? Well, honestly, it really started in Minnesota, where he was traded to on draft day for Ray Allen. There in Minnesota, KG and Stephon Marbury actually had a little bit of success together. I mean, they made the playoffs every single year they were together. They both had solid numbers for young players, but during the 1999 lockout season, Stephon demanded a trade. And when this happened, a lot of eyebrows were raised because KG and Stephon Marbury had a promising future as two young players on a new emerging team. But Stephon Marbury, there were a lot of sources that said he wanted to go to a bigger market so he can have better endorsement deals. He had his shoes out, and some people even say he was jealous of KG's new big contract. Also, somewhat like the Kyrie Irving, LeBron James fiasco, Stephon Marbury wanted his own team where he can be the clear man, and he did that, and he went to New Jersey, where he had some actually historic moments. He had his own 50-point career high game, he made an all-star team, but they didn't really do anything, so he ultimately got traded to Phoenix and then to New York. When he got traded to New York, that made his fourth team in just 8 seasons, so that wasn't a really good look. And there in New York is where the trouble really started. Stephon Marbury and coach Larry Brown, they used to have a war of words, like they weren't on the same exact team fighting for the same goal. One time Stephon started it by saying, you know, coach is a great coach and that's what everyone says. We're supposed to be better than we are, but did that happen? No. And coach Larry Brown, with the championship and a lot of pride, he responded and said, so you're the best point guard in the league and the team is 17-45. Yeah, it's the coach's fault, obviously speaking with sarcasm. So they used to actually go at it and it just didn't work out. So the New York Knicks, having to make a move, they fired Larry Brown and moved Isaiah Thomas to the head coach, probably thinking that a player or a former player mixed with a new player, they can actually blend, but they couldn't see eye to eye neither. One time the New York Knicks, they were on a plane and Stephon Marbury found out he was getting benched by Isaiah Thomas, and he reportedly blackmailed Isaiah Thomas from some dirt he had on his name for getting benched. So that whole thing just didn't work out as well. Then years later, Mike D'Antoni was the coach in 2008 and Stephon Marbury got benched again. And years later, he responded and said it hurt more because of the way it was done. We were winning by a lot of points and he still didn't put me in, basically saying even in garbage time, he couldn't even get on the floor. And for a basketball player, that has to kill your ego. Then Stephon Marbury, he went to Boston, played a little bit, but eventually he was offered the veteran minimum and he said it was disrespectful or something like that. So he just took a year off and he was done with basketball. But on the bright side, Stephon Marbury went to China and went to the China Basketball League and turned into like the LeBron James over there. He won 3 championships in like 6 seasons. He has a museum. He has a statue in Beijing. I mean, he's like a big, big deal in China. So that's the good part. But in the NBA, it just didn't click in between the ears, and that really hurt his career. Now at the age of 40, he's planning a return, but I'm not sure if a team will actually take a chance on him because he's 40 years old. He has won 3 championships in another league, but I'm not sure how that will actually translate in the NBA because these players getting bigger, better, stronger. But I don't know. Maybe a team will look at his old resume and look at what he did and actually take a gamble on him. And he did have a good, you know, thing going in the CBA and the Chinese Basketball League, so I'm not sure. If you guys like this video, make sure you guys like the video. I wanted to give you guys, like, a quick summary of basically what happened to, like, a 2000s legend that I don't really hear people talk about enough. I heard him say he wanted to be in the Hall of Fame, his numbers and all that stuff. And quite frankly, I kind of agree with that. If you guys like the video, like the video. I'm kind of continuing this series of what happened to these NBA players' careers. Who do you guys want next? Try to find someone that people haven't already done because I don't want to do a lot of, you know, repeats of what everybody else has done. So try to find people that you haven't really seen, and I will try to give you guys that video. Make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe, do all that great stuff, guys. And until next time, stay tuned, Jack.
All I want to do is go out trapping with shooters. Wrist so froze, you should see I have a nose. Shorty say she down and up and flex with all the shooters. Shorty, all you gotta get ahead of all my shooters. Oh, I came in, I just pulled it.